So, welcome back. Who are first time here? So our workshop is about to do cyber hygiene e-learning course. I was briefly introduced this e-learning course in my presentation, but right now my team is giving you all the tablets and usernames and passwords, and you can start to do the e-cyber course. The point is that this is based on our methodology. It's with the three different module. First of all is quiz. We are asking your current level and knowledge without teaching you anything. The second part is study material, when we are explaining all the things to you. And the third part is like an exam or test. It will take approximately 40 to 50 minutes, but most of you probably will click it over with 30 minutes. I will explain you what and how you have to do. All my partners here and colleagues will help you if this is necessary. And during this test, you will start to see the results in the screen. And then we'll all together start to analyze the results. Not only your knowledge, but all the rest thing what we can find out on you. This test is anonymous, because all those passwords and usernames are not with your own name. And one more important thing. This is not pass or fail test. You cannot fail. There is no right and wrong answers. There is only a bit riskier answers and less risky answers and more risky answers. So we are not to tell you what is right, what is wrong. We are giving you the risk assessment. How risky is your behavior in cyber domain? So this is the point. Because, yes? Who is the target users? Yes. All users. Single users. This is not technical, very technical. But the point is that doesn't matter. Doesn't matter that you're an engineer. It's training about cyber hygiene, but the result is risk assessment because your behavior in the cyber domain gives to your employee the risk assessment, how risky is your behavior in the system. Okay. It's not only about awareness, it's about your behavior. You may know lots of things, but you may not behave as you know. This is the question. The question is about your attitude and discipline as well. Because, for example, you may know what is strong password, but you are not using strong passwords. You may know what is two-factor authentication, but you are not using two-factor authentication. That kind of examples. In the real life, when the company will implement this solution, we have separate questions for the single users and managers, and separate questions for the specialists. But we are not asking from the specialist technical questions. For example, if from the single user we are asking question, what is strong password? It's pointless to ask from the specialist what is strong password, because we assume that specialist already knows that kind of things, yes? We are asking from the specialist, what is your opinion? How your employees in your company are able to use strong passwords? What is your opinion? Are your employees in your company, do they know what is two-factor authentication? Are they actually using it? From the specialist, we are asking opinion on your employees.
It's my job to check if somebody don't use two-factor authentication.
It's your job to check. Then you have good knowledge on that. Yes? You have good knowledge on that. But in your company, probably someone is chief of information security officer or risk managers. Do they know also this information? How? They ask from you.
Because we have some metrics.
Metrics? How you do this metrics?
It depends from your solution. If we're using two-factor as Duo provide to us metrics. We just check and match every computer, every people who use it, and we can
How you measure that all the people using two-factor authentication in Gmail and Facebook and LinkedIn?
Because
How you measure that? Yes, but how you measure that all your employees actually are using two-factor authentication in Gmail? How you force them?
It's a policy.
Yeah, it's a policy, but how do you know exactly are they actually acting by the policy?
Because when you create a new account, you add that account to that policy.
In Gmail, in Facebook, in LinkedIn.
Not sure Facebook or LinkedIn. It's not my right now field of working in LinkedIn or Facebook.
Yes. Yes, I understand, but you have probably the PR and HR people who are dealing with Facebook and LinkedIn by working matters as well, yes? How to check, are they using the two-factor authentication in Gmail and LinkedIn and the Facebook?
Only go to the Facebook and check settings.
You have to go to his account. How you do that? Yes, but the point is that we have to change the people mindset. They don't just follow your rules, but they know why they have to follow the rules, and they know why they have to do this. It's easy in the paper. We have everything by the policy, by the rules. In the papers, always everything is very beautiful, always. But the real life is never so beautiful as in the papers. Do you agree with me? In end of, in the bottom of every question and topic, there is a comment. You can give the free comments there. It's not mandatory. It's voluntary basis. If you have something to say, we are very gladful. You can say this is rubbish. This is those cases are not relevant, and so on, so on. So any comments are appreciated, but it's not mandatory. So it's optional. Of course, I forgot to say there is a different language. You can choose the English, Latvian, Estonian, Russian, whatever language you like, probably. Janek?
Yes.
On sul kõik keeled olemas? reach to the study material. As I said, in the quiz, we are just asking questions. We are not giving you the feedback, but in the study material, we are giving you the feedback. Right away, after you are answering the answer, we are giving the feedback. Is it a less risky or more risky answer? And after that, there will be the study material what explains you why this situation is that or another way. But we are giving this feedback only in the study material. As I see, there is a 5 users already reached to the study material. Let's start somehow to analyze the results. I will check one second what is the current situation here. Okay, there's not enough information yet. Okay, 3 more minutes, then we'll start to analyze the existing results. Ah, this one. Yeah. So we have to start to do some conclusions because only 15 minutes left to the end of the workshop. I can see that 17 users made the study materials, 22 users made the quiz, and 11 of users made all the tests from the beginning to the end. So what is first thoughts or first emotions about this that kind of e-learning course?
Translation.
Bad. If you're talking about the Latvian language. Yes, because there is a 12 different languages. We are using one university language department to translate, and unfortunately, we are not able to proof reading. Is it correct translation or not? Luckily, we probably will have soon a partner in Latvia who will start to do the proofreading in Latvian language. But if you forget for the minute the language, so but overall, correct results?
Because the language
is it so bad, really?
No, no, no. someone has this Wi-Fi network, yeah, and you should change your password, or you don't trust this technician and change your password. So it's actually.
There is a point. Have you ever made those personality tests? They're asking one same questions 5 times in a different angle. Yes? There is difference.
Yeah.
There is difference behind that. It's not.
Where is the difference? Because you change your password.
Because you don't trust anybody.
Yeah.
Or only this technician.
That's just paranoid question, and you don't trust anybody.
if you are looking the, 1 second. If you are looking the end result. For example, 1 second, then the point is, 1 second. The point is, it's quite easy to measure the knowledge about your knowledge about the Wi-Fi, about the internet, about the portable device, removable media. But did you show any questions directly measuring your discipline or attitude? No, exactly. That's the point. We are behind those different ways in answers, we are measuring how your brain works. This is one very good example. You have to be sometimes paranoid. Depends on your risk appetite, basically, how paranoid you are. But the point is, but again, you have to be a little bit paranoid everywhere, but you cannot be deeply paranoid because then the life will stop, basically. But the point is that imagine that you are chief of information security officer or risk manager at the company, and all your employees doing that kind of test. And you can measure only not the knowledge of them, you can measure how they actually behave and how they actually think of different topics. So this is for you also the risk assessment tool, not only the awareness raising tool, but the output of this result is basically the input for your risk assessment. You know exactly what you have to do after that. Not only that training, but maybe you have to change somehow the culture, corporate culture. Maybe you have to put much of resource to the information management, because as I said previously, there's a quite oftenly, as we heard in the beginning of this session also, we have all the policies and regulations. It's not good enough when the papers look nice. We have to understand are people actually using it or not. And We can basically compare the quiz, what was the first part, and the main test. So, this is average of today's classroom. This is average of today's classroom. And of course, if you are chief of information security officer, or this is your tool, you can find the people who answered something very bad. This is the fire sign. For example, let's take one user. User 37, whoever you are, please be quiet, yes? You had something very red. Let's check your profile. Information management. You probably answered somewhere that we don't have this policy. I don't know nothing how it's regulated in our organization. So if user will answer the way, you can collect users by different topics and start to deal with the specific topic to the specific user group who actually need it. Because it's quite easy to do the classroom awareness trainings. We put all the employees in the classroom, start to do some regular things, and half of the people says, it's boring. You can focus on the right people, you can focus on the right topics, You know exactly what kind of policies you have to make, you have to improve, you have to change, you know who are the biggest risks in your companies, and so on, so on. So let's take some other examples. 27. Okay. User 20. Average is seems okay. Test is so and so. The portable devices and internet threads are not so clear. Study materials, very good result. And the quiz, again, before they started to do the study material, the knowledge of people before the test and after the test. See the results. You can measure actually the quality and the point of this e-learning course. We can choose users. We can choose topics. You can compare different. You can compare different user groups, for example, in different departments. You have one department. You have another department. You can see what's the difference between the users, between the managers, between the specialists, how specialists will give the opinion on the companies, and so on, so on. There's a lots of different opportunities how to analyze the results for your next activities. If people don't want to answer, they basically fighting against this e-learning course. I don't want to answer. I won't going to do this test. You are fighting against this. It basically shows what? It shows your cooperation and your attitude.
Okay. And then this goes right.
In the different part. Okay. I can't tell you all the logic behind that, but the point remains. Yes, you got the idea. Couple of minutes to the end. Janek, what I missed?
Everybody who wants to have those results, please give us your email and we send this in the video.
Yes, if you want your personal results, give the business card with your username number from this login. If you don't want, it's fine. Because right at the moment, as I said, this is anonymous. We don't know who is user 20 in the red, and risky behavior user 23, and so on. So if you want, we can send all those results to you with the explanation, what we think, what you have to improve or change in your mindsets. And
just some people are still viewing, so it's not like closing in a minute. So we are not in the military, so you can take another 5-10 minutes and later on if you want to have the results. So even if you didn't finish the test, then we can send those results for those blocks what are entered. So basically like quiz. So only what we need to know is your username and then email where to send. And finally, if you feel that this is something that you want to continue or show in the company, then we have a representation by Latvian Partner Cyber Circle here. So talk to Ivars, he will help you. And we will be very thankful for the feedback.
All this feedback here.
And. With those users who gave the feedback, we would be very thankful if you can connect this anonymous name with the person and maybe to get that like verbal feedback, because the whole content, whole logic is based on very much on user feedback, what you are saying to us. We can think that maybe this is right, but you are the people from every day. And you can say that, okay, this is not from real life, or this was cool, look from that angle. This is very important for us, and we are very thankful for the feedback.
We hope to fix the Latvian language the correct way as well.
No, you will learn that.
Yeah. Or this one, huh? Exactly. So from our side, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this test and you feel that this is useful for you. And
we stay for 15 minutes.
Yes. or ask something. We have agreement with Tallinn Technical University. There is a 5 scientists doing 3 years work on with this methodology. Also, we have agreement with Tartu University who are doing the other science-related work to this topic. There is a lots of science behind it. This is not only that a bunch of IT guys sitting together and figuring out some questions. Okay. Thank you very much.